You lovers of mirth, I pray pay attention and listen to what I'm about to relate. Concerning a couple I overheard talking as I was returning late home from away. As I rode along, I met an old woman who sat neath a gap just a milking her cow. She was jigging a tune called Come Haste to the Wedding, or some other ditty, I can't tell you now. Then looking around me, I spied a bold stranger who happened by chance to come strolling the way. The weather being fine, he sat down beside her, but news on his man, the old woman did say. Oh, it's no news at all, ma'am, replied the bold stranger, for the people will wish that he never had been. It's a damnable rogue of a Daniel O Connell, he's now making children in Dublin by steam. Ah, children aroon, now replied the old woman, or come on, Joel, is he crazy at last? Is it sign of a war, or a sudden rebellion, or what is the reason he wants them so fast? Well, it's not that at all, ma'am, replied the bold stranger, for the children of Ireland, they're getting so small. It's O'Connell's petition to the new Lord Lieutenant, do not let us make them the old way at all. By this pipe in me mouth, then replied the old woman, and that's a strong oath on my soul for to lay. I am an old woman, oh, but if I was near him, I bet in me life, oh, it's little he'd say. For the people of Ireland, 'tis very well known, they gave him their earnings, though needin' it bad. And now he is well recompensing them for it by taking what little diversion they had. A long life to your courage, replied the bold stranger, and long may you live and have youth on your side. For of all of the girls in Ireland were like you, O'Connell could throw his steam engine aside. For I think every girl that is in this old country should begin making babies as fast as they can. And whenever Her Majesty calls for an army, we'll be able to send her as many as Dan. Oh, whenever Her Majesty calls for an army, we'll be able to send her as many as Dan.